Hello everyone, welcome back to our tutorial for the final exam. Here we are going to discuss how your final exam is going to look like and how you need to attempt it. So when your final exam starts on the 8th of June, this is something that will appear on your VLEs. It will have a final exam topic, it will have a question paper, and there will be different questions as well. For example, if there are three questions, you will have three Turnitin assignments. If there are four questions, you will have four Turnitin assignments. So this is how your exam portal is going to look like on the VLEs. Now, what you need to do here is that you need to download this exam paper. Once it gets downloaded, you open it up. And then you can see the details of the exam here. You can see that which course it is, who is teaching this course. For example, if I am teaching it, so whether I am teaching, whether this is academic writing or communication skills or qualitative research methods, whichever I'm teaching. What is the section code, the maximum marks that you can get from this paper. When it starts, for example, it starts on the 8th of June at 12 in the night. So you will have it, it will appear on the 8th of June. You will have the entire 8th, the entire 9th. And on the 10th, it is going to close at 6 p.m. That means you have around 2.5 days for this paper. For each paper, you will have different deadlines. So for some paper, you will have like 2.5, 3 days. And for some people, you have around 4 days. So that depends over here. So for each course, you need to go and see when it starts and when it ends. And then you need to prioritize ki kaun sa paper mujhe pehle karna chahiye, kaun sa baad mein karna chahiye. Jiski deadline pehle hai, wo pehle karna hai. Jiski deadline baad mein hai, wo baad mein karna hai. So you need to prioritize. You will have proper instructions. Obviously, you need to answer all the questions. You need to be precise and to the point. Even though I've not written 500 or 600 words, but you need to make sure how much you need to write. You need to read the questions and understand them before answering them. You may make assumptions as long as it does not contradict with anything in the paper. Agar isme koi cheez clear nahi hai, aap usko mein assume kar sakte hain as long as kisi cheez ke against na ho. Plagiarism is strictly not allowed. 0% plagiarism. Agar 1% plagiarism bhi aaya, to main marks deduct karungi. So you need to write everything in your own words. You need to give proper APA in-text citations and a reference list. As I mentioned, that it is an open book exam. Obviously, you'll be using different references, different books, different internet sites and all. So you need to give a proper reference of those books and of those internet sites that you are using. Zaruri nahi hai har sawal mein iski zarurat ho. For example, if it's a communication skills exam and I have asked you to write a letter, pick letter ke andar you don't need to give in-text citations or a reference list. But if you are writing an essay or if you're writing a research paper, then you don't need to do this. You simply obviously if you're writing a letter, you don't need to give in-text citations or a reference list. But if you're writing a research paper, if you're evaluating a research paper, if you're writing a synthesis essay, you need to give proper in-text citations and a reference list as well. So you need to, you know, critically analyze whether a paper needs it, whether the question needs it or not. You will have different questions. You might be asked to compare. You might be asked to critically evaluate. You might be asked to discuss. The question will have proper the detail of what you need to do. It might have a statement and it might then tell you what to do. It will give you proper marks as well. So it will tell you how many things that you need to do. You will not be asked to explain or define or do anything like that. You will have more critical evaluation kind of papers that you, questions that you might have to answer. So you can compare, you can critically evaluate, you can analyze whatever needs to be written here. So this is how an average paper is going to look like. Now, if I go back here, if I go back to the paper of what you're going to do, once you download it here, you're going to make different word files for each question. Question number one ki word file alag banegi, two ki alag banegi, three ki alag banegi. Now you will have like four different word files. If there are four questions, you will have four word files. If there are three questions, you will have three word files. Once you're done with that, you're going to open up here and you're going to see that utni hi yahan pe assignments bhi hai. So you open up question number one. Once you open up question number one, you can see that there are instructions here. Wahi due date yahan par hogi, wahi timing hoga. Remember, if it says 6, to agar aise yahan isme 6 bajenge, Turnitin aapka assignment nahi lega. So you need to make sure that you have a proper internet connection. You need to make sure that you have proper internet electricity as well. To uske liye behtar ye hai that if your exam starts on the 8th, you start working on it on the 8th, so that by 9th your papers are ready. आपके पास जब आप upload करने बैठे तो आपके पास 4 folders ready हो, and you just need to drag and drop. You need to make sure that you are uploading correct word files on the correct question as well. क्योंकि अगर आपने गलत कर दिया तो automatically you get a 0 in there. If you upload a blank file, you get a 0. If you upload a wrong file, you get a 0. जब तक ड्यू डेट नहीं आ जाती, यू मे मेक एज मेनी अटेम्प्ट्स एज यू वांट अंटिल द ड्यू डेट. एक दफा ड्यू डेट आ गई, उसके बाद जो है ये अलाउ नहीं करेगा. एज इट इज अ टर्नटेन असाइनमेंट, यू कैन इजीली चेक योर प्लेजरिज्म हियर एज वेल. इट विल टेल यू योर सिमिलैरिटी इंडेक्स एंड देन यू कैन करेक्ट इट एज वेल इफ रिक्वायर्ड. सो मैक्सिमम मार्क्स आर हियर, ड्यू डेट इज हियर. यू नीड टू बी वेरी केयरफुल विद द ड्यू डेट. यू नो दैट लिविंग इन पाकिस्तान वी ऑफन हैव internet and electricity issues, so you need to make sure that you have things ready at least 3 to 4 hours before the deadline. At least 3 se 4 ghante pehle aapki cheeze ready honi chahiye taki aapke paas 3-4 hours ho upload karne ke liye. So as I said, for each of the questions you will have different portals as well. So aapne yahan pe dekh liya, aapne 8th ko isko download kar liya, aapne alag alag word ki files bana ke questions kar liye. Before the due date, आपने यहाँ आपने इसको open किया और आपने हर appropriate word file यहाँ पे कर दी. Question 1 की यहाँ पे कर दी, question 2 की इसके नीचे कर दी. So this is how your exams is going to look like. You will have a proper question paper and then you will have different questions as well where you need to attempt as well, where you need to upload as well. So if you have any further questions regarding the exam of how the exam is going to be and how you're going to attempt it, you can post it below this video as well. I've told you the sample questions as well. I might give you a paper to evaluate. I might give you an essay to evaluate. I might ask you to write something up. I might ask you to explain a concept using different references. So it will be more practice based or scenario based that we are going to, that you will have the questions about. As far as the topics are concerned, all of the topics are important. All of the topics are included. Everything that you have studied in this course is included in your exam. Everything that you have studied in the face-to-face classes, everything that you have studied in your online classes, all of that is included in your final exam. A list of that I'll upload in the in your groups as well, so that you know exactly the topics that we have covered and you can attempt and you can you know go through them, revise them accordingly. So if you have any further questions, you may post it below this video and I'll be happy to answer. Thank you.